Welcome to PJ's Q&A section. A YouTube subscriber, Danny, sent me a bunch of a picture about this stone table and asking how would I do the surface. This is a really, really interesting surface. So we are not gonna reproduce exactly the same, but I would like to walk you through my thinking process in this tutorial. So my initial thinking is if we have a curve on the top and this kind of zigzag follow, you know, the shape like this all the way to the bottom, and then we also have another one the same like a zigzag on the bottom right there, and it's also we have the profile like this, we should able to do the sweep to all the way to the end. To have a better control, we can have another one right there. So this is my initial thinking. However, if we do the sweep too, then we may not have these things going up and down like this. So my thinking is we may need to sweep twice with the sweep to command, and the third line we're going to have is follow some sort of shape like this, and then we want to go, this is the first surface we want to do sweep to, this is the second surface we wanted to do the sweep to. So let's try that method and see how it works. First of all, let's create a block to refer as our table. We want to go with the center here and want to hit it with the zero for whatever size we are going to do, and then for whatever height we are going to do. This is not going to be print or executed, so I'm just coming whatever size there. Let's lock this one because this is going to be your reference and we want to draw directly on top of it. First, we want to draw the one on the top. So let's go with the endpoint, and then we're gonna kind of doing some sort of spontaneous zigzag shape. And of course, when you are doing this, you might need to have it a little bit more detail. I just want to walk you with you on my thinking process, right? And because our old snap is on, as you can see on our perspective, is snapping everywhere. So let's go ahead to project to the C plane. This kind of things happen a lot, right? So we just need to constantly using this very useful command. All right, the second one that I like to do, let me hiding this one first, and we want to do the same thing, but we don't want to be repeating the same like first one. So we try to do something like this, like this, like this, and again you're gonna go up and down into some is inside, some is outside, or something like this. All right, and then so this might be too steep there, so let me move there. Again, you see it's snapping everywhere, so we're just gonna do project to the C plane again with delete original input. All right, so now we have two curves here. I'm going to move this curve to the top right there, and then gonna turn on the one on the bottom. So that's a two rail there. We need to creating a profile. All right, so the profile I'm creating, I want to make sure that it has a little bit curve like what we have here. It goes straight down and that's a little bit curved to the peak and coming down like that. So we can do whatever profile that you like, but I'm just kind of trying to guess here. We're gonna go somewhere like this and going a little bit peak coming up and coming down. I'm going to make sure that I have that ridges there, so wanna like stop my curve and starting the new one so that I can maintain that very sharp peak over there. So I'm gonna coming back here and back to the endpoint. Maybe I have too much point, so I did it one, so I have this like a little bit more straight. And let's take a look on this one. We are going to join those and let's take a look like this. All right, and of course it's snapping everywhere. Let's use the same command, projected to the C plane. All right, so now we have that one there. We are going to move it back to the beginning. So let's go ahead, use the move tool, snapping into an endpoint and coming over here. So we got something like this. Let's give it a try. Surface sweep to rail one, rail two, cross section, and then we got something like this. All right, it's not bad. I mean, if we wanted to have, you know, more control, we can do that. But that's kind of giving us a signal that we are doing the right thing. The second things we are going to do, if we look back the image right here, it's going up and down like this. All right, so we might need to do a little bit change. We're gonna delete this first test there. I'm gonna come into the front view. And in my front view, I'm gonna draw something like this. I'm gonna go something like this, up and down, going up, going down, flat, something like that. All right, and then we want to project it to the C plane as well, because I bet we must snap in somewhere else. Okay, so now this is flat. That's moving this one to here, all right, anywhere close to the surface. All right, so then we will need to thinking about, okay, how are we going to separate the first curve in order for it to sweep, right? So I'm just gonna do a test by splitting this into two. We are going to use the split command with the point somewhere here. Okay, and so that become two curve there. Now looking at the side view and we look back the image, this one need to come out a little bit. So I'm going to move this one actually out a little bit, something like that. So let's do a test. We're going to sweep two. This is gonna be our first rail, second rail, and this will be the cross section. So we get first one like this. Second one, this is the first rail, second rail, and this is a cross section, and we get something like this, right? So it is a little bit rough on that. It's because our curve is not touching. That's why you create this opening right there. So we need to do something over here. The key of avoiding all the gap in between is your cross section need to touch your rail, so you will have less issue on that. So what we need to do is we need to rework on this one. Let me put a reference point right there so we know where we are going to snap, and we are going to snapping into this endpoint and come over here and kind of going like this one and snapping into that sharp point. Right, so that's the first one. The second one, what we wanted to do is starting right there, that point, and we're gonna have it coming down and all the way to the bottom, right? And then again, you can do adjustment if you want to. We are just want to do a test and see how it goes. So now this one, we need to on my right view, need to project it to the construction plane. And let's move it from this point to this point. All right, so now we're readjusting our curve. Let's give it a try. We're gonna do the sweep two, rail one, rail two, cross section, and then we're gonna have something like this. We're gonna do another one, rail two, cross section, and we have something like this. All right, so let's take a look on our render view, and then we do get something like this, right? Be really careful on some area, you might have it fall over because it's too tight over there. The way to adjust it is either make it not too dramatic or giving a multiple profile in between, so that way you won't have that twist. So let me unlock the desk and hide it so you will have a better scene on this surface. All right, so I hope that answers your questions. Please like and comment and share my video so that I can reach more people like you who want to learn Rhino. Thank you, and I will see you next.